And welcome back to House Call here on NextSportsStar.com. Your host, Tony House, broadcasting live each and every day, 9 to 10, from the nation's capital, Ottawa. As I said, moratorium on the CBA, NHL. That's just me. Told you I was going to keep bringing on hockey guests, as hockey does play an important role here in our lives. And one guy I know who knows a lot about hockey, former NHL goalie, and now he's the goaltending consultant for Hockey Canada. He'll be the guy, I guess, we can either praise or blame for what we do over in Russia for the World Juniors. Ron joins me. How you doing, Ron?
I'm great, Tony. How are you?
Good, thanks. Really appreciate the time. And, you know, again, maybe since, you know, there's so much fallout right now, I'd like to get your thoughts on what went down this week. What a, as well, Gary said, a real roller coaster of emotion. You've been a player. Now you're out of the game. Just give me your thoughts and, you know, frustration, disappointment, of course. But let me know what you think.
Well, you know, I've been part of these negotiations before, and, you know, I remember the peaks and the valleys as you're working towards a new agreement. But the one thing we were always sure of is that as players, they had capable people that would, you know, step back after there's been something thrown on the table. They always, you always hear these little breaks where they step back. And the reason why they do that is they have capable people that'll say, this is what is going to happen if you take this, not what could happen. Mm-hmm. It'll be what is going to happen. This will be the fallback from that. So, and all of a sudden you go back, and they say, okay, past experience with other owners. They like to spend this. They'll overpay this. They'll do this. And they actually put it all together and say, this is what's going to happen. And I remember Bob Goodnow the 1 year saying, guys, save your money. He says, I'm prepared to go into December and January. And that year, coming to December and January, guys were really struggling. Mm-hmm. And of course, Bob ended up losing his job because he didn't get the deal that the players wanted, but he knew it was going to go longer. So the preparation going into this, there's a lot of knowledge on both sides, and they know exactly what's going to happen when this deal is done.
I'm trying to figure out the exit strategy for Donald Fehr and the players. You go, let's say we lose the year, you come this fall, doesn't it just continue to get worse? I'm just trying to figure out, because most businesses, they do have an exit strategy. So what do you think, you know, what's the leverage? And obviously, I think the owners have the leverage, but, I mean, losing a season, just not sure about that.
Yeah, and the owners will always, you know, the owners are brilliant people because in the earlier years, not all of them owned their own buildings.
Right.
You know, now they own their own buildings, so it's not even like you can set up something or do something because they have all the facilities, you know. So, yeah, they hold all the cards, but on the other hand, for whatever reason, there's something going on in there to prevent them from wanting to get this deal done. And, you know, for me, I really believe the biggest concern for the NHL is, and it's never changed, it's never been addressed, is that they need to handcuff their own owners.
Mm-hmm.
The problem is that the deal gets done and they said, now guys, just be responsible. And they just can't do it. You know, and I'm not going to lie to you and tell you that the players are deserve more money. That's totally not true.
Mm-hmm.
But on the other hand, some of these owners just can't do it themselves and they ruin everybody else. That's what happens in these agreements.
Right. Well, let's shift gears. I mean, if you want to get your hockey fixed like most Canadians over the Christmas holidays, I know you sacrifice a lot. You're heading to Calgary for training camp and then over to Russia. You're the goaltending consultant. Let's talk about the four guys you're bringing into camp, maybe break down the competition that is, and what are you looking for ultimately when you select or give your opinions on the goaltender selection?
Well, I think what we've really come across lately is the extreme pressure that our team's under to win gold, but more importantly, the extreme pressure the goalie feels that he has to be the difference maker. He has to be the reason why we win gold. So, you know, for me, I'm looking for a strong personality kid that really has really strong beliefs in himself to the point that he's almost really cocky and arrogant, because he's the guy that might be able to just withstand that and believe that he can be a difference maker. You know, so from a standpoint, mentally, I'm really looking for someone strong. The other thing is I'm looking for a guy that can bounce back. If he gives up a goal that, you know, maybe puts us behind, can he make that next save that we need him to make, or is it going to go the other way? So these are key things for me because, Tony, in all honesty, all four of these guys are capable of doing special things. But it's the guys that can mentally, you know, raise up to another level and stay calm and relaxed at the most important times is the guy that we need in the net.
No, and a huge position. And as that goes, I'm wondering, you know, obviously they're going to take your, you know, your input about the goaltending, but, you know, you gotta put together the right mix of team and look at even the defensemen who are the last line, other than the second last line of defense. So you must have a say in the overall team makeup.
Well, they asked me for advice, which is nice. We're all in a room and we all discuss players. And I'm around all year watching the goaltenders. I also make support on players. Not to say that I have a great deal of say, but you will, if I ask them of importance to bring out, they're more than willing to hear it from me and they take it into consideration. So we're all in the same room trying to figure out what gives us the best chance to win a gold medal. And the greatest thing about Hockey Canada is that they all, as a group, they want to do it together. There's no one that's saying, I'm the guy, I'm running this. It's a really tight group that just tries to come up with the best way for us to win.
No, and you said the makeup of a goalie, you're talking about confidence and arrogance. If you look at all the great players that are coming to the camp, I mean, there's so much depth and breadth, as always, on the Canadian roster. In speaking with Coach Steve Spott, what is his sort of – what's going to be the MO of this team? What type of team is he going to build based on the type of players that are coming in?
Yeah. On what kind of team we're having. Are we going to have a high-skilled team that's going to say, you know something, let's go out and get them, boys. Let's not worry about this. We're the better team. We're the better players. Are we going to play a certain style that maybe we're not fast enough? We have to be grittier. We have to get puck feet, finish more checks. It's all going to be related to what the kind of roster that we want to put together that we feel gives us the best chance to win a gold medal. It's such a tough tournament to win because all these other teams have really improved. They're fast, they're strong, but we've always had the one advantage, which was the Canadian heart. And sometimes I think that hurts us a little bit because we want things a lot more than other teams. The European teams are like, I remember the Russians won, the semifinal game the one year, and they were ecstatic because they said, for sure, we're at least getting the silver medal. Mm-hmm. You know, for us, it's only one medal. We want to play for a gold medal. So last year's team, our coaches did a phenomenal job to get those kids to play for a bronze medal. And to be able to do that, to win that game, I know people were disappointed, but as a group, we were so ecstatic that those kids found a way to dig deep and win a bronze medal because that kept our streak of something like 15 straight years with a medal. And I think that was important.
And maybe breakdown, maybe high level. I'm not sure, you know, you don't know exactly who's on other teams, but the favorites are probably the usual suspects. You've got Canada, the U.S., Russia, Sweden, Finland. What have you been hearing, and, what's the competition like?
Well, you know, we got a good taste of the Russians, their game never changes, but it's so difficult to play against because they couldn't care at all about the defensive part of the game. So when you get them down, you have to keep them down. You have to put your thumb on them and fish them. And then they get discouraged. You know, they feel they're too far behind. But they'll cheat. You know, all of a sudden, you'll be playing 5-on-4 in their end. You know, and there's a guy that just changes in their own end of the ice, just changes. And they're playing 5-on-4. And that guy comes off the bench, and he's standing at center ice. He's not coming in to help. You know, so things like that you have to be aware of. The Swedes are bigger, stronger. They've worked a lot on their skills. They're going to be really, really good. With them, though, I feel that we got to get under their skin. They're very undisciplined. They want to prove that they're big and tough and that they can play against the Canadians. And that's where our discipline is going to be crucial against the Swedes because they are undisciplined.
Yeah, and well, I'm just gonna, before I let you go, you know, one team's gain, hockey, Team Canada, the World Juniors, is another one's loss, and the Kempville 73s are going to miss you for the month that you're gone. You've been a player, you've been a coach, now you're into management and ownership. How has the experience been? I mean, the team has struggled as of late, but have you enjoyed the ownership? And tell me from the first 30 games, your experience with being a Junior A owner.
I've enjoyed it. Obviously, I haven't enjoyed the losses. I take them personally. I take them hard, and they will bother me, and I have a tough time sleeping nights after games sometimes. But, the one thing I can say is that these are incredible kids that we have on this team. It's the greatest group of, kids that have given their time to the community, getting out there and doing things. And so off the ice, I've always said that we've been extremely successful because of the character kids that we have. It's just a matter of making them play better as a group and as a team to give us better chances to win. And obviously we made a lot of changes at the deadline, and players that for the most part we didn't feel were going to be back in the league last year, except for maybe Jesse Luchier. And so we're trying to make decisions. We want to keep the character the right way. My concern for the next month being gone is that Hilly, the trainer, is going to have to do the skate sharpening. And that's been a big part of my job. So I hope that he's trained and ready to go.
Yeah, well, I'll make sure of that, and I'll make sure there's really no slippage. How's that? That's it. Yeah, so hey, enjoy your time. I know you're gone for a month. It's a sacrifice that you make. I hope you bring the gold home, and I'm sure you'll do everything you can. But enjoy the holidays, and we'll see you in the new year, Ron.
Cheers. Thank you very much. And if I can get a gold, that means I have all three. So I'll be pretty happy with that.
That's a great array of color, for sure. Have yourself a great one.
Thanks.
All right, take care.